Okay, so we're gonna start prepping our tuna au poivre, which we're gonna take our skinless bloodline out tuna loin. The very first thing we're gonna do is remove the chain. Butcher yields for this, we're gonna have to record it in two phases. The first is gonna be what we're doing here. We're gonna square off the tail, and this will be for tartare. Square off the nose a little bit, also for tartare. We're just gonna trim a little bit down that side. All that is gonna be good for our tuna tartare 3-ounce portions. Now we're gonna take this piece and we're gonna shape this a bit. And the way we're gonna do that is we're gonna get some of our plastic wrap. We'll roll out a real nice piece. We're gonna get our tuna over here. We need to crust our tuna all the way around with our pink peppercorn au poivre crust that we made. It's pink peppercorns, green peppercorns, some grains of paradise, parsley in here. I want to get this on all sides. Just kind of keep rolling it around in that on your plastic. This is going to do is we're going to form this like a nice barrel tenderloin so we can cut what looks like filet mignon out of our tuna. I have to put a little bit of pressure on it just to break the muscle a tiny bit. And then we're going to roll it this way. To do this a couple of times so we can get this really tight. Ideally, if these sit in your refrigerator overnight, you'll get the best result. I'm gonna go one more time. Possibly get that. And that's going to be our tuna tenderloin. So as I said, when we record our yields, we're going to have to do this in two parts. We're going to weigh this piece, and then we're going to have our 3-ounce tuna tartare portions that we weigh. We will then take this piece and cut it. We're going to cut this into 8-ounce pieces, and we'll record how many 8-ounce tuna portions we get out of this. So this will be yielded twice. An 8-ounce portion out of there. So I'm just gonna cut this end of the plastic off. We'll cut our 8-ounce portions. And you'll see how we have a nice, pretty round medallion out of it. To finish making our tuna au poivre, we need to prepare the vegetables for it. And we're going to prepare those by using the mandolin to cut our carrots. And what we're going to do is cut long strips of carrot that we're going to grill. Okay, we're going to need about 3 or 4 per portion. Also going to grill some green beans. So what we'll do is we're going to take those, we're just going to do a little bit of olive oil on them, salt and pepper. I'll put these right on the grill. We're gonna let those grill for a minute, get a nice little char on them. While we're doing that, prepare the rest of the vegetables. We're gonna need a little bit of our roasted mushrooms, some cipollini onions, and some of the peewee potatoes. We're gonna pick some tarragon. Rough chop that. Just rough chop. We'll add that in here. Then we'll go check on our carrots. See how they're doing. Getting there. Okay, now these vegetables can be prepared ahead of time and chilled and just saved for service, all mixed together like this. Take our tuna steak and season that with a little bit of olive oil. Bit of salt. Don't need any pepper, obviously, because we have plenty of pepper all around this tuna steak. Then we're going to throw this on our grill. Obviously, we'll cook our tuna to whatever temperature the guest is requesting. I'm going to cook this one rare. Nice tuna steak and our vegetables. I'm going to go ahead and plate some of the vegetables on the bottom here to give the tuna a tiny bit of height. Have it sit up off the plate a little bit. Add a little bit more vegetable on the side so we can see it. Our white aquave sauce here, and we'll drizzle this completely around, make sure we give the guests enough sauce.